So this is the first Autopilot 2.0 car that I have seen. And right away here, I noticed as I was pulling up, we got the new side markers. Let's see if I can block some of the sun here. We got the new side markers with the side view cameras. And then we're just gonna walk around one with the windshield here. And then we got the downward facing cameras in the glass. It's a little hard to see through that one. Go around and back, and I'm gonna try and leave his license plate out of this. But if we go down to the backup camera, they have a new style backup camera. It's a little different. I haven't gotten to see it in action quite yet. Rear window is the same. Go back, he's still got another camera on this side. Of course, the side marker. But the really interesting bit is how they changed. I'm gonna zoom in the best I can, or maybe come on the side. It is really bright out here. You got the triple autopilot camera, you got the long range, you got the mid range, and you got the wide angle short range. And they also got rid of the original rain sense, the automatic rain sensing wiper sensor and day-night sensor, looks like, or not. Oh, no, there it is. Right there, they still got it, but they changed it up a bit. We're gonna go over back over, my car's over here. We're supercharging at Pleasant Prairie right now. And we'll just take a look. And this is the original style sensor for the rain sensing wiper. And then the single autopilot camera with the heat strip going around it for defrosting. Now, this one uses more of a traditional style heat strip. There's three heat strip lines going across to melt any kind of snow and slush. So I'll try and do some post video processing to see if I can clear up the image with it being so bright out. But in terms of Autopilot 2.0, this has been the first one I've seen. I'll be heading over to Highland Park for service on my car on Tuesday. So hopefully they'll have one there that I can get a little bit more in-depth upfront look at. Awesome.
Smile, cheese.